welcome to my YouTube channel AIERA. In the last video, we have saw how to explore the data using information and discrete methods. In this particular video, we are going to see how each and every attribute are correlated with each other. Basically, in this video, we are using a correlation matrix to find out correlation between each and every attribute. So without doing any delay, just move into a Jupyter notebook. So here I am in my Jupyter notebook. So working with pandas and working with dataset, the first priority is we required a pandas library. So I can simply import by saying import pandas as pd, and import os is used to change the working directory. Those who did not see my previous video about pandas library or pandas playlist or numpy playlist, it's my humble request to check playlist on my channel. So the next method or next step is to import data by saying ds is equal to pd.read_csv, and in close parentheses in its quotation mark housing.csv, and I can print df.head. df.head will basically give me a first 5 rows of from my dataset. In previous video I can explain what is head, what is shape, what is size of dataset. So it's my humble request to one and all to please access my pandas playlist. In previous video we are saw to how explore a data using information method and using a describe method. In this video we are going to see a very useful technique to explore a data by using a correlation method. So we can simply write df.correlation and close parenthesis, and in close parenthesis press a shift enter. So you can see over here the correlation of each and every attribute with respect to each other. But moving forward, we take a look how much each attribute correlated with median house value. So therefore I can create correlation matrix is equal to df.correlated. So my whole correlation matrix is now stored into correlation_matrix. Then proceed forward, I can simply write correlation_matrix. I can check correlation of median house value with respect to all attributes. So I can simply say correlation, that is core_matrix median_house_value dot, I can sort it according to a descending value, therefore I can simply write ascending is equal to false. Can press a shift enter. So you can see over here, so my correlation will shown in over here. So you can observe one thing, the correlation coefficient range from -1 to 1. When it's close to 1, it means that there is strong positive correlation. For example, the median house value, that is my median house value, tends to go up when my income goes to increase. Means my median house value and my median income have a linear correlationship. Every time if my income goes increases, my median house value will also get increases. When the coefficient is close to -1, it means that there is strong negative correlation. You can see a small negative correlation between longitude and latitude. Furthermore, coefficient close to 0 means there is no linear correlation. The one of the important tip regarding correlation matrix, that the correlation coefficient only measures a linear correlation. It may completely miss out a non-linear correlation shift. So therefore, we check or we use another method to check correlation between each attribute, which is known as Pandas scatter matrix function. So we can simply say from Pandas dot plotting import scatter matrix underscore matrix. I can press a shift enter. My scatter matrix library or my scatter matrix function is getting put. Basically, a scatter matrix function plots every numerical attribute against every other numerical attribute. If there are 11 numerical attributes, you will get a 11 square is equal to 121 plot, which will not fit on page. So let's just focus on few attributes. The few attributes such as median house value, median income, total rooms, and housing median age. So I can simply write my attribute over here, and in square bracket I can create a list of my attributes. My first attribute is median house value. So avoid delay, I can simply copy paste from over here. And my next is median income, and instead of 4 I will take only 3 attributes here. And my last attribute is total room. So I can press the shift enter. So my attribute is stored in a list format in my attribute function. Next step, I want to call a scatter matrix function, a scatter matrix underscore scatter underscore matrix in close parenthesis df with attribute my attribute in list format. So I have to use a square bracket over here. Next is I have to mention pick size is equal to in close parenthesis 12 by 8. To print this function or plot this function, I require a library such as import matplotlib dot pyplot as plt. Don't worry if you didn't know about it, that library. After Pandas library, we are creating videos on that matplotlib library or how to visualize a data by using a very beautiful or interesting graph. And I can simply say matplotlib in line. Then press a shift enter. Shows an error. Total rooms. Okay, it's a typing error. And here you can see don't know why it will take time. Okay, sorry for my typing mistake. And plot list in line. We did not get print. So for basically we did not require this command line. So I can comment it out and press a shift enter. Will take a time to generate graph, and you can see over here a very beautiful graph. By using this graph, you also correlate your each and every attribute. So this is enough for today's video. If you like this video, please like it, share with your friends, and subscribe my YouTube channel, that is AI Era. Don't forget to press the bell icon and never miss an update. Thank you one and all.